like Fred Sanford, you know, they find things and things like that and they take home. If you stay away from the smelly parts, you'll be all right. So this fellow found a silver cup in the landfill, somebody's garbage, and he took it home. You know, of course, in the landfill, it was filled with layers and layers of dirt,
yes,
and grime, scratches, scrapes, scars, a little bit of rust here and there. So it wasn't all that pretty in the landfill. He took it home and began to work on it. Gave it some tender, loving care, TLC, we call it. Buffing it, shining, washing, cleansing it. Had a little solution, you know, which you dip.
Dip it in.
Dip silver cups. Dipped it. Oh, boy. Anyway, I'm going to stay on that. Let's dip it. I'm going to go off and dip it, but I ain't going to dip it. So after he finished, it was what we call a nice vintage item, vintage, unique, you know, peculiar. Yes, it became a valued piece for him. Someone had thrown it out, but he worked through all the layers of grime and was able to restore. To renew it, made it useful again. The writer of this story went on to say that humanity, much like this silver cup, the curse of sin came about. And layers of grime, dirt was upon us. Scratches, scars, sin, just horrible stuff. In the fullness of time, God sent Jesus to find us and to save us,
yes,
and to wash us up, to scrape off layers and layers of stuff,
feel,
grit, just cleaned us up.
Praise God.
Some people resisted, you know. And remember when Jesus was washing feet? Peter, I think, said, Lord, you shall never wash my feet.
Wash my hand.
Lord said, if I don't wash you, you have no part with me.
Yes, yes.
Well, applies to the story as well. And it applies to us if we don't allow him to wash us.
Yes.
We don't submit to his cleansing power. Have no part. He will do it. It's up to us to let him. So now let's continue. Then let's continue. Let me review a little bit from last week. Revelations 3, and the message was entitled "Lukewarm." And you know those folk in Laodicea had become lukewarm. Neither hot nor cold. The water there was not hot enough to comfort those who needed spiritual healing. It was, you know, in hospitals, you know, you need sterilized stuff. You need the water wasn't hot. Won't help nobody spiritually. And it wasn't cold enough either. Those who were in the desert, and sometimes you need a cool glass of water. Their water was neither hot nor cold. Useless. And the Lord is saying their spiritual lives were the same way. Useless. Lukewarm. Because it's lukewarm, the Lord said, I'm going to spit you out of my mouth. I can't. Mouth rinse, maybe, but I can't use you for nothing spiritual. And what happened to these folks? What had happened was, they became materially wealthy. They became rich folk. Mm-hmm. You know, the wool, the black wool, and the south, and all the money. They became self-sufficient. Verse 17. A It says, Luke 3:17, you say, I am rich, I have acquired wealth, and do not need a thing. But the Lord, but you don't realize that you are wretched, pitiful, poor, blind, and naked.
Wow.